guys. I am here with Coco the Yorkie. Her pet parent likes a fusion-inspired style, but does not like the legs being so full. And she likes a tied-up top knot with tipped ears. So let's get busy. Right, Coco? Gonna get busy. So she likes a really short and tight on the trunk of the body, but she wants quite a bit taken off these legs. So to do that, I'm going to start by tipping her ears with a 15 blade. Good girl. I'm going to trim the body with a 7 blade. You're okay, baby. Yes, you're okay. So I'm going to trim this body in typical fusion style. We are keeping hair on the tail. But since she's getting her legs trimmed shorter, I am not going to drop them down as far as I would if we were having the flared bell-bottom legs. You're okay, honey. Don't worry. You're okay, you're a good girl. Very quickly. Following Coco, I will be doing a Maltese with a true fusion style legs, very full, so that you can see the difference between the shorter legs and the fuller legs. That's a good girl. There we go. Now we're going to put her in the tub, get her washed and blow dried, and then we will finish the trimming after the bath. I love working with Yorkies, Maltese, toy poodles. Love, love, love the toy breeds. Shih Tzu. Japanese and croutons. All the cute fluffy dogs. Now I'm using a good quality ear wash and filling each ear canal up with the ear wash. This will dry up any moisture that may have gotten in the ears, loosen up wax and debris. Rub the base of the ear and allow the dog to shake its head if it will. Sometimes they won't when they're hooked up. You shake, shake.
She says, no, just get me out of this tub, please. Just get me out of this tub. That's, I demand it. I demand it right now. Yes.
Okay, fine. I shall take you out of the tub.
Yes. Look at that sweet face. Look at his sweet face. Oh, so cute.
Alrighty. Disinfect the tub. Mm-hmm. Basically, I disinfect all the areas where the dog touches. At the end of the day, I break the whole thing down and disinfect really deep. Next, I'm going to go back over the clipper work on the body with the 7-blade. You're okay, honey. Don't worry. You're just fine. That's not gonna hurt the Yorkie. No. Not gonna hurt the Yorkie. For me, it's my personal preference if we're going to go with the legs shorter to leave a little more hair on the body. But I do know this pet parent likes a very tight body. And as a pet groomer, I can't go with my preference. I always go with the pet parent's preference. Until they tell me otherwise. Now I'm going to do her pads of her feet with a 30 blade. Good girl. Next, I'm going to do around the eyes with a 10 blade and go back over the ears with the 10 blade. Come here. You're fine. Yes, you're fine. Okay. Got to do around your eyes. Now I'm going to brush off all the hair off the feet. All these little clippings get all stuck in their feet when we're trimming the body. sap stuck in her hair. I'm just going to cut that out. Now brush these feet all down and out. She's just the best little girl. Aren't you? You're just the best little girl. Where's my comb? There it is. Now I'm going to scissor around the feet. You're okay. Quit worrying. He's all right. I'm taking good care of you. I didn't even use any noisy tools. Taking good care of the baby. Yeah. She's so worried. It's okay. Where's Coco? Coco. It's okay, Coco. It's okay, Coco. Come here. I know you're worried, huh? Yeah. Why are you so worried? I'll go around the feet some more as I'm trimming the legs. This silky, flippy hair on the legs, we're scissoring it shorter. So I'm just going to use my comb to bring it up and scissor it off over the comb layer by layer and letting it fall back down and seeing how it looks. And then the back of the leg, I'm going to go from the elbow down to the carpal pad. And then straight down to the table. I don't pick up legs like this to work on them. Mostly the only probably breed that I actually pick up the whole leg to work on it would be the poodle. Sometimes you'll see me trim the back part of the leg with the leg up. When I do that, I go from the carpal pad to the elbow. Never from the carpal pad to the table. Because we lose a fill of hair that we really need to keep the leg with a pillar shape. So now we're gonna do this side. Comb the hair up, snip it off. Layer it down. I don't have a cameraman. I do all this single-handedly. So sometimes my hand does get in the way. And I apologize for that. If I had a cameraman that could go around me, that would be different. But I'm a one-man band. So I do what I can. On these back legs a bit, and we'll just pick over the opposite legs, that not the ones I'm actually working on, as I go around, see anything sticking out of place. So this hair here, I'm gonna comb this up again, just snip it off. This hair right in here, I pull forward to snip off. I find to get a better blend that way. I'm going to take the back of the leg pretty tight. Now I can pick up the front of this leg and I'm going to round it up towards the last rib. It's looking nice. Good. So to keep the tail in balance, I'm gonna do her tail like a cute little plume. If you'd like to see other styles for Yorkies, I have a Yorkies hairstyle options video. It's very nice, covers all different tail styles, face styles, body styles, leg styles, all sorts of options for your Yorkie. So you can see from the back, I don't have poofy hips. The legs are tight, going down, somewhat of a terrier style. Got some mats inside the backs of these legs. I'm just snipping them out. Over everything and pull it all together. And after all the legs are done, for the most part, I'll start working on the face. I am using Kinchi shears. These are flipper shears from Kinchi. They're very nice. 7-inch. Got a nice feel to them. A shear's got to feel good in your hands in order to do nice scissor work, that's for sure. let's start working on the face. Right now, her face looks too long for her body. So we're gonna bring it up. Put a knot in her mustache and push that out. If she'll let me. So since she's wanting to face that way, I'm going to put the groomer's harness tether on her. So that I can keep her in this direction pretty good. She's got a lot of hair growing into her mouth. You can see all that dark stained hair. Gonna snip that out. Sometimes they don't like the sound of those scissors coming down on that thick hair. That's something they have to get used to, not only the feeling of the scissors closing down, but the sound. Desensitize your dog to that. You can have your scissors over here and a treat in your hand. Pick up another treat. Hold the head. Don't touch them with the shears, but get them used to the sound. Give them a treat. And do that a few times a week until the dog is no longer bothered by it. This longer hair on the back of the ears, I'm going to pick this up between my fingers. At the same time, kind of pushing the ear forward. So the ear's here and the ear is protected by my fingers. I'll just trim that hair shorter back there. Do it on this side too. There we go. And she has quite a bit of short hair right in front of here. And you can either let that go through the stages of growing out, or you can trim it. I'm opting to trim it. Since she's a client dog, not my own, I don't know if the client wants her to go through all the stages of growing that out. Now, dropping the nose down. Turn that. Tilt the head downward around this up. Looking pretty, Coco. Yorkie hair is always a challenge to trim. Between the blending of the colors, the silkiness of the hair, the little flips they get in their hair, and their squiggly personalities, getting a perfect groom on them is challenging, to say the least. That could be why they're shown with full coats so they can look their best. You know what I mean? It's just one of those breeds, they're not gonna be perfect. And you have to get that in your head that sometimes they're little messy missies. And even if you do get them perfect, 5 minutes later, they're gonna go roll around in their bed. Not perfect no more. You Yorkie owners know exactly what I'm talking about. Get your Yorkie all washed and brushed and combed and looking beautiful. Get their hair all tied up out of their eyes. Put them on the floor and look at them 5 minutes later. Why do I even bother? Why do I even bother? Somebody tell me. Cuts on my thumbs and the band keeps catching right in it. It's like, ow. You groomers know what I'm talking about. Can you relate? And this doesn't look good. And I gotta do it again. You think you can stay over here, please? You're not helping. All right, I'll try it again. So this is something you have to be careful of. If you tie the hair up to get it out of the way after the blow dry, and then you caught up some hair that you really didn't want in the top knot, it's gonna train that hair to flip back up. It's gonna be kind of a pain to work it out. I'll show you what I mean in a minute if she'll turn her head to the camera. So I'd accidentally caught this piece up when I tied it up, and see how it's all curled and flipped. That's just from having the hair put up. For a few minutes. The bows are only meant for quick pictures. They're not designed to stay in the dog's hair long term. This is a tassel top ponytail. When I trim these, I get them up where I want them, and then I kind of feather the hair around the bow so that you can see the bow. See where I want to keep the hair's length. Now to fix this. Let's see. Bring this back this way. wet that. We're almost done. I like to keep the hair off the table so I can see where I'm going. If there's too much hair underneath the dog, it all blends in with the dog and it makes it kind of hard to see if you're doing a nice job or not. Put this head up, comb everything down, make sure it looks nice underneath. Don't be bratty, Mom. Stop. Behave. Not to be, anyway. Coco. Coco. Uncle Bye-Bye. She said, where's Mama? All right, Coco's all ready. All right, Coco's all finished and ready to go home. I am here with Emmy Jane, the Maltese. She's getting a fusion-inspired style. And we're going to make her all pretty.
Yes, we are. We're going to make her all pretty.
She's so sweet. I just love her. All right, Emmy Jane.
Let's get you cleaned up.
She's got extra bows in her hair. She's got a crown of bows.
Yes, she's so cute. You're fine. Oh, poor baby. You are absolutely fine. It's a good girl. Good girl.
I'm cutting the bows out of her hair, but I will fix them for the pet owner so she can have them back. I just simply prefer to cut them out. It's much more comfortable for the dog. But I'll show you how I fix them. It's real easy. Good girl. So I'm gonna clip her hair right where it lays.
Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Come here.
Great baby.
Now we're gonna go put the baby in the tub. Yes, you can go put the baby in the tub. Come on.
You want to be careful with the shampoo around the eyes. Should be careful with all shampoos around the eyes, but especially the ones that are whitening and brightening.
She's the sweetest puppy ever. Yes, you are. Look at that face. Look at her sweet, sweet face.
Don't I groom the most precious dogs, like, ever? I mean, seriously. All the dogs I groom are just such amazing little critters. And they have such amazing pet parents. For her conditioner, I am using iGroom Squalling Care. Using a good quality ear wash in the ears to dry up any moisture that may have gotten in there and loosen up earwax and debris. looks like a swimmer's ear kind of product. Drying up that moisture.
Girl. You're a sweet baby. You're a sweet baby. I know, I'm gonna get you all wrapped up. And you all need some warm. Yeah. It's okay.
Disinfect the tub.
Thank you.
mad at Miss Suzanne. Did you get mad at Miss Suzanne about your nails? I'm so sorry. Had to do it. You idiot. I had to do it, Miss Emmy. That's a good girl. Yeah, she's a good girl.
So to get her hair out of the way while I am working on her, you notice I split it in the middle. That's because I plan on putting two bows. And if you put one band in while you're working on the dog and you plan on putting two bows in the end, the hair is going to look off a little bit. So by splitting it, it gets it trained going in the direction I want it to go while I'm trimming the dog. You'd be amazed at the little things that can completely throw your groom off. All right. I'm going to go back over her hair with the 5-blade on the trunk of the body. Whenever you're changing blades on your Artero Spectra, be sure it's in the 10-blade position before you put the new blade on. I used to wonder why my blades wouldn't go on right, and then I realized that it needs to be in that position. It's like, oh, now I see. Okay. Good girl. I'm gonna brush out the feet, brush all the hair off of them. All the little clippings she picked up when I was trimming her back. Get all those little clippings off the table. And now we're going to trim around your feet. It's okay. Going to mist it with iGroom Magic Mist to help reduce some of the static in the hair from the blow dry.
You're all right, baby. I know you're okay. I should go turn off the air conditioner, huh? That vent's blowing right on this table and you just had a bath. Let's go do that. I'll be right back. She says, thank you, Miss Suzanne. That AC was blowing on me and I was cold. I was very cold. Yes, it was cold, Miss Suzanne. Okay, back to work. We turned off the cold air. You're good. All right, let's trim around these little feetsies. So I'm gonna pick up all this hair around. Trim off some of this longer stuff. Stand. You're fine. If you would like to see more detailed instructions on her haircut, I have a video that's more of a how-to video for her. This one, you're just watching me do her. That's my good baby. Good girl. So when I'm trying to get these big fat feet, big flared feet with bevels, I'll start by pushing the hair back so I can get the lower part of the foot quite close. And
without cutting the longer hair. And after I get that all done, that's when I set my bevels. Yeah. So I want to get some of this hair growing in her mouth out of the way. Good girl. Being very careful not to cut her tongue. There we go. So the Yorkie that we did first, basically her pet parent likes this style with the legs short. And you can see the big difference of keeping the legs long and keeping them short. The shorter style doesn't have the flared legs. You can get a shorter leg, like say on a poodle, and still flare it, but when they have silkier hair like the Yorkies and the Maltese, you really can't get the flare unless you have a lot of hair. Good girl. So pretty. It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you.
Trying to make me hold you. Is that what you're trying to do? Is he trying to make me hold you over here? You just keep backing up? Yeah, till you're cuddled right up here. Is that what you're doing? Oh, it is. It is what you're doing. I know, it's okay. I'd love to hold you all day long, but I gotta get your hair cut. Yes, you do. Gotta get your hair cut. Yeah.
So these kind of haircuts do take a lot of combing. Every time you pick up and move the dog, you've got to comb them again and get all the hair in position where you want it before you can start trimming. You want the dog standing four square as you start, because if they're not, it's not going to look right when they do stand four square. You're going to cut hair you don't want to cut. If they're slouching or arcing up their back or anything like that. So yesterday in one of the comments on one of my videos, somebody had mentioned that they're afraid to do certain things with their dog because they had tried to cut out a knot and actually cut the dog. So here's the rule with cutting out knots. Don't pull the knot out towards you as you go to cut. Like, don't find it and pick it up and cut, because you're picking up the skin too. The skin's coming with the knot as you pull up. When you cut, you're gonna catch skin. If you're gonna cut out a knot, the rule is don't pull the knot out towards you as you go to cut. Like, don't find it and pick it up and cut, because you're picking up the skin too. The skin's coming with the knot as you pull up. When you cut, you're going to catch skin. And that will help you to not have any accidents. Or just leave the knot right where it's at if you're good with your scissors, but don't pull it up. Stay. Being careful not to cut her eyelashes.
Oh, so cute. Let's do this. Now this is not a correct Maltese top knot. This is more pigtails. One of these days I'll show you guys how to do a correct Maltese top knot. Well, not 100% correct, but close. The people who show Maltese, they have an art all in itself of putting up a Maltese top knot. You need a pillow? I don't have time to fool around, ma'am. No, I don't. Put your bow on first. You too. Right. Hold still, please. Hold still, please. Okay. In my mouth. Hate it when that happens. Trying to make sure it's straight over the ear. We don't want to catch up some of that ear hair in here because that would be uncomfortable. Now we have pigtails. So cute. Okay. You hear your mommy, don't you? Let's go fix your bows.
So as promised, we're going to fix her bows that I cut out of her hair so I can give her bows back to her mom in good condition. Going to take 3/8 inch ribbon, approximately the same color as the bows she had in. Going to burn the edges.
You're okay. I'm going to give you to your mommy in just a minute. I know your mommy's here. I know. But I gotta do this real quick, okay? Gotta fix the bows.
So after all those are burned, we're gonna take rubber bands, latex bands. We're going to loop them over the ribbon, put some hot glue on there, and then glue the ribbon with the rubber band right to the back of the bow, so it's fixed.
Easy peasy pie.
That way you don't have to try to warp those bows out of their hair. You can go ahead and cut them and still save your bow. Because if you keep trying to work those bows out of their hair so you can save your bows, your dog's not going to like having its top knot done, because it's going to become accustomed to a little bit of tugging and pulling. All right, they're all fixed and I can give them back to mom in good condition.
Well done. All right. Miss Emmy, come here.
I thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the notification bell so that you don't miss any uploads. And stay tuned for a member shout out today. We'll see you next time, guys. Bye.